right.
Greetings, everybody. Redbeard here for another edition of Rasslin with Redbeard, the YouTube show where I, Redbeard, take you to a professional wrestling event somewhere in or around the Carolinas to give you a sense of what it's like to be a fan traveling the highways and byways in pursuit of this great passion that is professional wrestling. And to get off on a tangent before we go into anything else, I will go ahead and say that today's travel definitely tested my passion for this business. We are, of course, on Easter weekend here. This is Friday, April 14th. This is Good Friday, of course. It's Easter weekend, travel weekend for a lot of people, spring break, vacation, whole nine yards. To get to where we are this evening, we're in Spartanburg, South Carolina right now. I have to travel up I-26 west from my home of operations in St. Matthews, South Carolina. I will say that I've had worse experiences in traveling, but today really pushed a lot of buttons because there were a lot of little incidents, little things on the road that didn't require people to slow down, but that added a lot of delays to my travel. I probably should have been here about 45 minutes to an hour ago. It's about 5:35. I was hoping to be here in this area around 4:30 so I could have something to eat before going into the arena and getting a spot. But as it is, probably just going to do this real quick here and go inside whenever the doors open and get some nachos or whatnot, and that's going to be supper. But I just really want to say, if you're a motorist traveling along 26, please don't act stupid. Please, if you see just, you know, a car off to the side of the road or whatnot, keep going at an agreeable speed. Don't slow down. Don't slam on brakes. Don't do anything crazy like that. It's going to impact 40 or 50 or 100 other people. It's really done a number on my blood pressure, so I apologize about having to go off on a rail or a rant here to start this episode, but needed a moment to vent before we did anything else there. But regardless, we are going to move onward and upward with what we're talking about here this evening, and that is our opportunity to see WWE NXT here in South Carolina. This is, as I mentioned, Friday, April the 14th, 2017. And we're going to be here for what is evidently going to be one of the final appearances of a couple of people who've really become a couple of superstars, I shouldn't just call them people, who have become top draws on the NXT brand. And we're talking specifically about Shinsuke Nakamura, Ty Dillinger, and The Revival. The Revival, of course, we're going to go ahead and cover our heart for those guys because that's a couple of local boys there, Scott Dawson and Dash Wilder. We've watched them for upwards of a decade and how they've come up from doing their thing in recreation halls and bars and everywhere else to where they're now bona fide WWE superstars. So kudos to you two gentlemen. Cannot speak highly enough of what you guys have done with your careers. We'll say surprised in some ways, but we'll say also not shocked, because as I've made as I've stated in comments online before, it's hard to hold down passion and talent, and that's definitely two things those two guys exude very much But as we said, this is going to be one of the final appearances on the NXT brand for Shinsuke Nakamura. That's going to hopefully draw out a lot of people here this evening. We're not too sure on what the card is going to offer. The whole thing here could be kind of a mishmash of stuff because we've talked about somewhat previously on other episodes and on other pieces of content that I have here on the channel about how NXT is kind of in a refresh mode at this point in time. They don't have the big star power that they did at one point in time with a lot of the guys who've now gone on to the main roster, you know, like a Finn Balor, for example, is a name that comes immediately to mind. Those guys have moved on. So, you know, we've got Bobby Roode now. We've got Cassius Ohno. We've got Hideo Itami, who's finally healthy and able to return to competition. We've got the AOP, the Architects of Pain. A lot of guys who are coming up. A lot of guys who are still going to be able to make an impact. I think there's going to be some surprises here this evening in terms of what the card winds up being. I'm looking forward to seeing Andrade Almas, previously known as the Sombra, in Lucha Libre circles there. We're really looking forward to seeing Aleister Black, who was formerly Tommy End in independent circles. Just, you know, some guys we haven't seen before, some guys we haven't seen in a long time. So I think it's going to be an interesting show. I think one of the more interesting aspects beyond just the talent is going to be to see how well this show actually draws. Because if you're a fan of the show and if you've watched this show for any length of time, you know we've been to this building. This is the Spartanburg Memorial Auditorium, by the way, that we're sitting outside of right now. We've been to this show a number of times, or to this venue a number of times for various events. Big Time Wrestling being the primary one that we've seen here. Upwards of 10 years ago, actually saw WWE's incarnation of Extreme Championship Wrestling here in this building as well. Has a lot of history here. There is an old Crockett ring in this building. A lot of people sort of tease that as being a historical fact that is unique about this facility, and that there is an old piece of history that has just had a permanent home here. It's in pieces, but it's here. And it's one of those things where talent who've worked here in the past, they say, oh, well, we saw the Crockett ring that's there. So there is a lot of history here. A lot of good things happen here in terms of just the shows that come here because they draw well. The town has always supported wrestling. But be that as it may, because of the cost of the ticket, because of the roster being what it is, I'm not sure how well attended this show might be. You know, we bring up Big Time Wrestling, and you know I've had my issues with them in terms of various decisions they've made from here and there, but they bring in guys like Ric Flair, Ricky Steamboat, Sting, others who are major draws and would bring a big crowd in regardless of where it happened to be. Here in the Mid-Atlantic, of course, they bring in even more, but we're going to have to see whether or not NXT does the same kind of business, especially with the ticket prices that they were charging. The floor seats for this show were $75. $75. That's a lot, in my opinion, for this show. I think that they probably would have done better to have had the starting price point be $40 and then go from there, because $40 was the price point for the general admission bleachers, which are the lower level, sort of off the floor seating positions, if you will. And then the balcony general admission, which is what I bought, was $15. The trigger to this whole discussion, as far as talking about how much the tickets actually cost, is not just the face value of the tickets. You're talking about adding on the Ticketmaster fees as well. So, for example, in the case of my ticket, I said it was $15. It was actually $20. In the case of my $20 ticket, it winds up being $35 after you figure in all the fees from Ticketmaster. I think with the fees, the floor seats might have been $94 or $95. So that's just a lot of money for what amounts to the, I hate to say this, the B or maybe even C-level show of WWE at this point in time, depending on how you want to rank Raw and SmackDown. But, you know, it's just, it's one of these things to where in discussing the patterns of the business and then how well it's doing overall, you have to take a look at, because, you know, it's one of those things where you hate to think that they wouldn't draw well and that they wouldn't do well here being a WWE product, but the fact of the matter is, with those prices and with this being a holiday weekend, it might not do that well here, and that's bad because you'd hate to see them not come back to this area. because the Mid-Atlantic is still surging at this point in time. There are a lot of shows happening this weekend around the area. You've got Palmetto Championship Wrestling running back at the Warrior Warehouse. Champions with Attitude apparently is still running tomorrow, although for some reason their Facebook page disappeared here the past couple days. Not sure what was going on there, but they're supposed to be having their show tomorrow. And the ball keeps rolling in terms of the shows that are happening around the Mid-Atlantic, PWX, AML, Old School Championship Wrestling. We're still waiting on WrestleForce to do something. I'm going to point my finger at you there, Bob Keller. But we're hoping that they get going here at some point in time. But yeah, just, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on as always. A lot to look forward to, a lot to enjoy if you're a fan. I put together a post in the Carolinas Professional Wrestling Awards group here on, or there on Facebook, where I listed the Facebook pages, links there too, of every promotion that I was aware of in the Carolinas. And I don't know how many there were, but good Lord, it just seemed like there should be no weekend of any point in time that does not have some opportunity for you, if you're a wrestling fan, to go see a show in this part of the world. So, that all having been said, you know, we're going to have to wait and see how things go here this evening. I'm going to have a good time regardless. I'm hoping the balcony isn't too terribly crowded. I'm hoping that I'm able to get in line over here and actually be able to get a good position. I will say that this episode, which is number 32 in our total rundown of episodes of Rasslin with Redbeard, may be kind of gorilla shot because I'm using my big pro camera that I usually use to record matches and whatnot, but when we go inside, I'm going to be using my cell phone. So we'll see how that transitions. We'll see what kind of content I'm able to get, because, you know, I was at one of these NXT shows previously. I forget what episode number that was, but we did one last year when they were in Charleston. And didn't get any real video at that show other than a couple of entrances and a few spots here and there because of the fact that I was sitting on the second row, but also right by the entrance ramp. I had one of their guys come in and tap me on the shoulder at one point and say, "Hey, buddy, just remember, pictures only." I was like, sure. Not really wanting to get kicked out of this one, but at any rate, hopefully we'll be able to get a few more pictures and whatnot for this show because of where we'll be sitting, a few more videos, I should say. And just, you know, be able to turn something in that's good here as a continuing legacy of the Rasslin with Redbeard program. We do appreciate you guys hanging out with us here on the channel. We've got a variety of things going on. We're continuing with the Rebels, Rogues, and Redbeards podcast. We've got new episodes of Rasslin with Redbeard coming out at a pretty good clip here. Hoping to get some match videos from possibly CWA tomorrow. That'll be later on. I shouldn't say tomorrow, because tomorrow will be a relative term, of course, in terms of when you guys are actually watching this. But, you know, a lot going on the channel, a lot to look around at and enjoy while you're here. So please, if you would consider giving us a subscribe. Also, likes are never looked down upon as well if you enjoy what you're seeing here on the program. So all that, or on the channel, I should say. I get tongue-tied the longer I talk, but regardless of all that, we're going to go get in line, and we'll see how things go here for WWE NXT in Spartanburg, South Carolina. Appreciate you guys tuning in. See you in a few. All right, wanted to point something out while we're still here in the parking lot. One thing that you will, if you're not a frequent attendee or anything at the Spartanburg Memorial Auditorium, is if you have trouble getting here, just come in on Church Street on Spartanburg and look for the old Krispy Kreme donuts. If you turn there, you're going to be exactly where you need to be in terms of getting in the parking lot. And one thing I want to point out is that you see this guy standing right there. Let me get my finger out of the way so the camera will refocus. He's waving people into a parking area that is private. It's $10 a car to park there. You do not have to park there. You can actually park anywhere in the actual lot that's associated with the Memorial Auditorium for free, provided you get here in time to get a parking space. Any of the other lots around here that you don't get access to for free, that's kind of on your own there if you get here late or whatnot. But again, you do not have to park there, as my finger blurs the perspective of what we're looking at. Just so you know. This is evidently one of their older trucks. As you can see, this one features, among other people, R-Truth. and Wade Barrett and Eva Marie, all people who are not necessarily big parts of the roster anymore. Everybody lined up waiting to see the show. How you doing?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Well, thank you, ma'am.
You're in the balcony, sir?
Yes.
Okay, you can either go on that side of the balcony or up these steps.
Okay, thank
you. You go on that side, nobody's sitting over there.
Thank you very much. Hello again, everybody. You probably weren't expecting to see me in the daylight again in this particular episode, but as it may occur, there sometimes are things that don't quite go to plan with this show and with pretty much anything that I do. Now, last night at the show in Spartanburg, I had a fantastic time, great card, great action all the way around, great venue. Did not get enough video to really, in my opinion, warrant a full-scale version or episode of this show. It's one of those things where I could put a whole bunch of pictures because I took dang near a couple hundred in this thing and make it kind of a slideshow, but let's be truthful here. You didn't come to YouTube to watch a slideshow. You came to YouTube to watch video. So, that being the case, I included the video that I did shoot, a couple pieces here and there. The main thing that we had was the tribute that the guys did there at the end of the show. I had to chop that up a little bit for the sake of not being on the verge of including anything that might get me in hot water for a copyright infringement. But regardless, that is what it is. We're here as part two of this episode at the CWA event, that being the Champions with Attitude show here in Orangeburg, South Carolina tonight. This is just an example of how wrestling fans have the opportunity to travel around and see various shows. For example, we drove 2 hours up the road last night to Spartanburg. The show here was about 15 minutes, well, maybe 25, honestly, from where I live. So there was no reason not to come over here. Beautiful day. This is, again, Easter weekend. Fantastic opportunity to get out and see a show. So we figured, why not? And we're going to bolster this episode by giving you a twofer and showing off some of the local talent that we have here tonight. Not real sure, though, on what's going to be on this card. I do know that we've got names like James Drake, Josh Cutshaw, we just saw arrive here a few moments ago. I believe that Tracer X is on this show. Let's see, who else? Believe the main event might be a cage match between Michael Judas and Stephen Hunter. Don't quote me on that, but we'll see how it turns out. This is supposed to be kind of a show that's gimmicked around the steel cage aspect, because they were involving that with a lot of their promotion and whatnot in advance of the show. For some reason, their Facebook page up and disappeared here a couple days ago. Not sure if they might be revamping that or what could be going on, but I tried to get some additional information here and it suddenly went tits up, so no idea what happened there. But regardless, we're looking forward to the show here this evening, looking forward to seeing what we can have as an addition to the channel and getting some match videos and highlight clips out there. Would like to talk a little bit about the show last night and just the experience overall. I love going to that venue because it's a great little spot. There's literally not a bad seat in that venue. I would encourage you, if you ever do go, not necessarily to get the floor seats. If you get the floor seats, get front row. But anything other than that, you're kind of paying too much for it, in my opinion, because you're going to have somebody in front of you. And the seats are about this wide as far as the actual reserve seating on the floor goes. So you can see I'm holding this up. This is not quite matching up with how wide I am. So, yeah, probably not as wide as you are either. But regardless of that, the balcony seats are great. The bleacher seats are great. They're valuable, in my opinion, because you can save money on those. Put that towards merch or whatever else you might want to do that evening. So, you know, it's just a great opportunity to see shows there whenever someone is running in the Spartanburg Memorial Auditorium. The show itself was fantastic. I will say it was not quite as good as the one they had last year in Charleston. That card had a little bit more name power to it. The match between Austin Aries and Andrade Almas, always want to call him La Sombra, was just phenomenal. A lot of aspects of that card were really memorable, but still, the one last night was a lot of fun. I'm going to chastise myself here a little bit because there were some people on that card that I did not know their names. I know I've seen a couple of them before, but I couldn't tell you who they are right off the top of my head, so I'm going to have to do a little bit of research in putting this together to learn about who those talents were. It was interesting to see Patrick Clark come out and do kind of a, I won't call it a Prince gimmick, but it's kind of the Prince slash Jimi Hendrix type thing. People were chanting Purple Rain at him, so, you know, whatever. The other thing that I bring up that was funny from the crowd response department was that whenever video highlights were shown of Roman Reigns being thrown around in the ambulance by Braun Strowman, there was a massive round of applause for that. So it's amazing that something that in years past would have turned somebody into a huge villain have now succeeded in making Braun Strowman the hero of the people. So, but overall match of the night had to be the tag team match between The Revival and Hideo Itami and Shinsuke Nakamura. Such a unique combination of talent there. Very pleased to be able to have seen that in person, because you'll probably never see it again, at least not in that ring. You may someday see it in a Raw ring or a pay-per-view ring or something like that, but it won't be in an NXT ring. So, great match there. The main event was a lot of fun. Kind of ended in turmoil there with, you know, a no finish type scenario. But still fun, because you had that segue into those four guys being able to talk about their experiences, where they've been, where they're going next in terms of their careers on the main roster. And just, you know, a great moment there to have those guys, two of which are from the Carolinas, being able to have a good little moment there in the ring. That all having been said, I would definitely encourage you, if you've never been to an NXT show, to check it out. They're smaller shows. They usually play in more intimate venues. The whole thing, in my opinion, is just a great way to connect with fans and to really grow those talents into something that will be immediately visible and available on the main roster. Perfect example of that is a guy like Ty Dillinger, who did not have anything like indie credibility as far as, you know, going from a, you know, a background like PWG or whatever independent scenario to the WWE product. He's somebody who has been in their system. The fans latched on to him and has shot to the top, and he's a tremendous performer. So, well, you could almost put Shinsuke Nakamura in that mold, but as big of an international star as people, you know, he's already got name value there. Dillinger is a better example because of the fact that he kind of came from nowhere. So, but it's a great system. If I can get my tongue straight there, it's a great proof of this methodology that they've adopted in saying, okay, we're going to have a feeder system that comes here. You have a year or two to kind of develop. If it works out for you, great. If not, you might have to go somewhere else for a little bit. But if it works out for you, then guess what? We're going to try you on the main roster and go from there. So it couldn't be better in terms of the fan experience, in terms of the talent development cycle. You know, it's just a great thing that they've put together. So kudos to them for all they've done. I'm going to stop gushing about NXT and whatnot now, because I want to try and go ahead and get into this venue, because they do first come, first serve seating for the most part, and I'd like to get a good seat. So we're going to head on inside. This is part two of our episode 32, which I guess is appropriate that we had a twofer since it's an even number. But we are here once again in Orangeburg, South Carolina on April 15th of 2017. Champions with Attitude. Hope it's a good show. See you in a few.
see this cheater hold on to the ropes. So do me a favor, why don't you just restart this match?
Thank you. She's got some in her teeth, some in her mouth, some in her pocket, some at home in a drawer. Right there is Honey Boo Boo's grandmother. And standing in the middle of the ring is the absolute best big man in professional wrestling. Standing in at 6 foot tall, weighing in at 271 pounds. I am the new age enforcer, James Drake, and I am simply better than you.
Spot somewhere between the restroom and the all access area, and there's a flood of people coming this way right now. Probably should have waited to do this until after they were moving, but even so, big crowd here today. I would say this is probably a sellout, but they're assembling the cage for the final two matches right now, so we're gonna see if we can make our way through this crowd of people and maybe get a snack here and maybe talk to some people. But yeah, having a good time. Sodas are cold, nachos are hot. Take it with 10 bucks, what can you say? Good times in Orangeburg. See ya.
right, folks, there you have it, our coverage of NXT and CWA here this evening in Orangeburg, South Carolina. We'll wrap up our comments on these two shows by highlighting a couple of things. I want to go back in time to the NXT show and just the environment there for a moment, and talk about how unique that area is once again. Not only because of the history of that building, but also because of the area itself. If you've never been to that part of Spartanburg, South Carolina, as you approach the Memorial Auditorium from, I'll say, the 26 I-26 side of town there, you'll notice that there are not one, but two Krispy Kremes. One of them is an older building that's still there. It's more or less, it's sort of a storefront. They bring fresh donuts from the one across the street, which is a new location, and they sell them in both houses, more or less. But as you come in and you're standing around outside, the overwhelming aroma is that, of course, of fresh donuts. And as we were standing around in line there yesterday, it was all you could do to not run over there and grab a dozen. My favorite is jelly donuts. I've always loved jelly donuts, but you can probably look at me and tell I've always loved jelly donuts. But that's a sensory experience there. And here tonight at CWA, not a bad show, entertaining, but it's one of those things to where I think I've been critical of them in the past, and I'm going to say it again here. And I probably am stupid for wanting this from professional wrestling, because it's, again, professional wrestling. But I was talking to someone, I won't mention their name because of who they are, who was at the show this evening in the crowd, but I was talking to them, and they agreed with what I was saying in that there was a scenario this evening where during the women's match, you have Samantha Starr, who is suddenly assaulted by Dustin Bosworth, who ran in and literally punched her square in the mouth. Now, obviously, it's wrestling, but still, if you look at that scenario logically from a storytelling standpoint, he punches her. What should be the next thing that happens? She probably should pass out. She probably has some sort of an injury. She should, be laid out cold there, more or less, because he's a big guy. Definitely jacked from the waist up there, anyway. Looks like he's been skipping a leg day there a little bit, but anyway. it's just, he's got huge shoulders and his thighs were not there, but whatever. But the whole scenario where she gets punched, she's down for a few moments, and then she's back up and about her business there a few moments later. So it's just one of those little things from a storytelling standpoint where there were ways that they could have gotten, more heat on him and had, a better, more logical presentation. And here again, I know I'm asking for a cheeseburger from a Penguin, more or less, and talking about wanting logic from pro wrestling, but storytelling is what it is. And that is a downfall of a lot of stuff that goes on at CWA. Another one that I wasn't a big fan of here this evening was the finish between Josh Magnum and Josh Cutshaw, the Josh fight there, you might call it. You had a situation where Cutshaw had the ropes while he was pinning Magnum, had the pinfall at that point in time, and then here comes Timber, the CWA general manager, I guess he is, and says, oh, let's go ahead and restart the match. So whatever. And then, it winds up that Magnum wins in a pretty quick fashion there. But, it's one of those things. You're not going to be able to get your way 100% of the time. Someone like me is always going to be able to be critical of something like that. So it is what it is. And it really doesn't matter, because the truth of the whole thing is that the crowd ate it up regardless. This is a good old-fashioned southern town when it comes to wrestling, so they're going to take it and eat it up regardless of what it is. They're going to cheer the goodies and boo the baddies and do as they're supposed to. It is what it is. But it's been a fun couple of days of wrestling. I'm going to get off of here and stop running my mouth about things that I really don't know that much about, but I pretend that I do. Do appreciate everybody tuning in. Appreciate you being a part of the channel, watching what we've got on here. We're going to be adding more match videos, more podcasts from the Rogues, Rebels, and Redbeards program. Just a lot of fun stuff going on here. So we appreciate you considering the opportunity to subscribe to the channel. Appreciate your likes. Appreciate you participating in the channel in whatever shape or form you choose to do, whether that be sharing, commenting, whatever else. So that having been said, y'all have a good evening. we'll see you sometime in the future. See you down the road.